We get 5,000 TikTok followers, and Tony turns into a Hollywood, maniac.
A maniac. I'm just a little tired. I get it. I'm a little peeved.
Well, you were grinding.
I was
grinding. You were grinding.
Last night, I went to the club. I was wearing my velvet booty shorts.
Already a lie.
I was wearing my velvet booty shorts, okay. And I was out there grinding on them hoes. Grinding on them hoes. Grinding on them. On
Snoop Dogg. Is that Snoop Dogg?
Yes.
No, you were up late.
I was up late. I can't sleep anymore.
Dude, I haven't gotten good sleep in years.
Yeah. I think I haven't.
I just don't have consistency in my life.
Yeah. I think I haven't gotten sleep since NBC canceled the show Glee. Was it NBC?
Yeah, no, it was ABC, wasn't
ABC,
it?
ABC, and they or Fox. It was Fox.
It was Fox.
And they canceled Glee, and then one by one, every cast member was dying.
Oh, isn't that a thing?
Yeah, they're
there's like
all,
a Glee.
Yeah, they're all dying.
There's a Glee. Isn't there a name for it? The Glee curse.
Yeah, the Glee curse. They're like they're all just dead. Not all.
How do they? What, like drugs?
Drugs.
If I was on Glee, I would do drugs. I would do have done drugs. That was my legacy. Could you imagine being on your deathbed? And you're like, don't forget me. I was on season 2 of Glee.
Also, can I just say, you're shitting on their legacy. First off, it was a great show. And second
not
off.
Not true.
Yeah, it was.
Not true.
It was a great show.
Glee?
Yeah. It was a fun show.
It was about anything with musical numbers. Instantly, I can't do it.
Why?
Because I'm me, and you know I hate music. You know I hate musicals.
Why though? Why? Musicals bring joy.
I want to get this out of you.
Musicals bring joy.
So do I, but not for me. They kill joy for me.
So when you watch a musical and like a fun dance number's happening with great music, great song, you know, like two characters having fun on stage, you're just like, oh!
Okay.
I wish they were just talking and sitting.
What about the plot?
Yeah.
Okay, the only good musical ever. There's two good musicals that like are up to snuff for me. You want to know what they are?
I would love to.
I want to hear you guess.
Book of Mormon.
Okay, there's three musicals that are up to snuff.
I would say Book of Mormon because of South Park.
Yep. Yes, that's right.
There's three. So Book of Mormon.
Not just theater musicals. I'm talking like movies and
The Producers?
No.
All right. Chitty Chitty Bang Bang?
Not even close.
Singing in the Rain?
No.
Keep going. Is Dick Van Dyke a part of it?
No.
Then you're wrong. Dick Van Dyke is amazing.
You want to know what it is, Tony?
Yeah.
It's the Book of Mormon.
Okay.
Shrek. Which is technically a musical. And Shrek 2.
You know they made Shrek the musical.
That I cannot go for it.
How is Shrek...
Wait, did they make Shrek...
How is Shrek technically a musical?
Because there's a musical number. There's a few musical numbers.
No, there's not.
In Shrek? Yeah. Fiona Apple. The character. What's her last name?
Her name isn't lesbian acoustic guitar singer Fiona Apple.
Isn't there a
There's no musical numbers in Shrek.
Yeah, there are.
The only musical number
Fiona
is
no sings a song.
The only
in Shrek.
No, the only musical number.
He goes, "Oh, Merry Man."
Music.
There's music in Shrek, dude. I think.
No, the only musical number is Is Somebody What Stole Me.
All Star.
Yeah, but they weren't singing it. It was...
I was like, OST?
Yeah. It wasn't musical number in Shrek.
I'm pretty sure The Merry Men, it's a musical. It counts as a musical. Shrek is a musical. And I will die on this hill, Tony.
No, Shrek is not a musical. There's Shrek the Musical, which is a musical. But Shrek itself is not a musical. And what was your third choice?
Shrek 2.
Those, why?
I'm not a theater dude. I didn't grow up with theater. I grew up alone in my room.
I discovered musical at an older age.
What got you into musicals?
Actually, I did see one early on, Lion King, but that's kind of a very broad, and it's an amazing musical. Saw that as a kid, and then when I was in high school, I got into Mel Brooks, and then I watched The Producers, the original movie, and then he did a remake, because it went on, that Producers went on Broadway, and then he remade the movie, and made it more of a, he made it a musical, like 2005,
yeah.
And it's great. And then after that, I just started watching more musicals.
I think I have to warm up to the idea of a musical.
What do you mean you have to warm up to?
Like, or like
singing and dance. No, like it's fun.
I want to enjoy a musical. Want to enjoy it.
Have you seen Les Mis?
No.
No?
No.
Anne Hathaway bald. She just got like sexually attacked.
Jesus.
Yeah, and she's sitting there cold.
In the musical?
Yes. Okay. And she, not, I don't, I was like, maybe wow. In real life, but I don't know. But this is, we're talking about the movie.
Les Mis. Is the opening scene?
No, it's like 20 minutes in. She's sitting there bald.
Where is it set in? France?
Yeah.
Okay.
And she's sitting there bald. She's shivering. She's cold. She just got attacked. And she's like, I dream my life worth living. And we all cried in the theater, all of us.
Wow.
She's like in the movie for like 10 minutes and she got an Oscar.
Damn.
Yeah. She's great. It's a great musical.
And you cried?
Yeah.
Wow.
And Russell Crowe is bad. He can't sing. They casted Russell Crowe to play Jean Valjean, and he's like he's one of the greatest villains. And they cast Russell Crowe because
Life is the Highway.
What? No, that's Rascal Flatts.
Oh, Rascal Flatts.
What?
I'm sorry.
You thought they cast it. Rascal. Honestly.
Well, I'm out of knowing to travel alone. The next day here, the next day you're bald. Sometimes you cry on the floor in an alleyway alone.
That would actually be a fun Les Mis.
You got beat up in France. Don't know what you're going to do.
You stole a loaf of bread. And now you are going to jail. Life is a highway.
And then it just goes back to Life is a Highway.
Yeah, every time. It always goes back. She goes, I dream a dream my worst on the highway.
Rascal, it's not canon. You're not being canon with the highway. I don't care. This song's always canon. Life is a highway.
No.
So it's Russell Crowe.
Russell Crowe. And he was like in a rock band and he can't sing.
So he was like Rascal Flatts.
And he was just talking. He was basically like monotone, just talking. He just goes.
He's rapping.
Prisoner 523621, your time is through. Now look at me.
That's not that bad. I was entertaining.
You are a bad man. But it's not good. Everybody else like kills it. And then he's just like this the whole time. Like what if I talk like this, all right? Let's pretend I'll call you. Da-da-da. Ring, ring.
Hello?
Hello, Sean. How are you doing today?
Hello, Tony. I'm doing great. We're both bad singers.
You want to go maybe get some food afterwards? Maybe go see a movie and then we go our separate ways.
Life is a highway. I wanna run.
That would be fun to speak, live life through a musical.
I don't. Can you help me enjoy these musicals, dude?
Okay.
Maybe this is a good musical for me to get into because he's talking. He's talking. Yes. That's me. Like I'm like, oh, I like.
Les Mis is all music. There's no talking.
Okay, maybe it's I don't want to watch
it. It's all music.
How do you advance a plot with songs?
You just do.
All right.
You just do it.
And
what
then
do you
I
mean?
And then I went out to the store.
And I got mad. I got mad. The French are coming to town. We should do this. All right. If musicals were real life situations, right?
Okay.
What's a sad, dark situation, but we could set in like a musical?
Sad, dark situation. I'm thinking I'm in traffic.
You have such an easy life.
That's a sad... Are you kidding me?
It's a sad, dark situation.
How about I just got sued?
No.
All right. All right. Funeral. Oh, no. You really want to go sad?
All right. I am a police officer, and I'm telling you that your son just died in a,
Jesus
in a huge car accident. But it's
in traffic. Yeah, proving,
in,
okay.
In traffic, you're right. In a dark, in traffic. All right. But it's a happy-go-lucky musical.
Okay.
Hey there, Mr. Reilly. How are you today?
Who is at the door? I don't know. Maybe it's my son.
No, it's definitely not your son.
Officer, this is a surprise. What are you doing at my house?
I have something to tell you about your boy.
My boy. I do very love my boy.
Oh, no. That's not good that you love your whore boy, because you're gonna be very sad.
My boy, Jamie, he just got his license plate and his license. 16 and a half. He's becoming a man.
You shouldn't have.
What do you have to say about my boy? Is my boy okay? Officer, please.
You shouldn't have let your boy drive at such a young age. He only had one eye. The other eye was falling out. He was nearly blind. He drove a car into a gas station and it blew up the sky. He's dead.
My boy is very dead. My boy. He only had one eye. See, actually, I feel like this is, we're actually proving that musicals suck. Because I can't convey real... Tony, I'm an actor, as you may know.
We also, for comedic purposes, we made it a happy musical. There are
No. But even if it's a sad song, is always going to be happier than just a sad scene.
You've never just laid in bed with like a fucking album playing and you just like cry because the song is so like emotional?
No, I've totally done that. So Nirvana, that's what, Metallica.
Metallica has made you cry, but musicals can't.
I cry every time I listen to Metallica.
Enter Sandman.
Not Enter Sandman. No, that's kind of a rock out song. I'm talking about like One.
One makes you cry.
When it, yeah, dude. The imagery is beautiful. The imagery of One.
All right.
I'm just one. Burr, burr. You know, he's in the hospital.
That guy's voice will never make me cry.
Darkness imprisoning me. Well, I only cry on runs.
Darkness imprisoning me.
That's a sad...
It's funny.
What is your definition of a sad song? I am sad alone at home. I am sad.
I would say Lonely Day by System of a Down. Like 90% of Adele's discography. Like, that bitch is going through it a lot.
Yeah.
She had a rough... It seems like every man that looked
not
at...
Not anymore. Now not she's anymore. Fine.
I mean, but before she became Adele, it seemed like every man that looked at her fucking just like spit in her face and said, go back to the biggies, you fucking slop. And she's in her feels about it. I love Adele.
I love Adele. There's one song by Adele that I really like.
Sometimes I just poop alone.
That's not an Adele song.
Yeah, she poops alone a lot. Cause she
are you thinking of I Drink Alone?
Maybe.
I poop alone. Well.
So, do you think you'll ever love musicals?
I love music. I love music. You know.
Have you ever seen a musical live?
No. Nope.
That's your problem.
All right, well, let's go see a musical.
All right. Wicked.
I would see,
Wicked's coming in.
I would see Book of Mormon live, but that's because I love comedy.
But
that's
that
not
doesn't count. We have to go to a legit, like Wicked, maybe.
Is opera? I would go to an opera. Because opera is like
what
high art.
The fuck? What the fuck is wrong with you? We just spent the first 15 minutes. I had to defend musicals to you, and then you're just like, but operas. Now that's my shit.
I mean, I've never seen an opera, but I'm sure that would be a moving experience. Because it's like, you know, that's an opera. But a musical is very ditzy.
I think. Da-da-da-da. So you just like people yelling. Like, yes, just, like women running away when they're running away. You like them yelling. You like children yelling. Sean just likes yelling.
I like when adults yell. In art.
In art, all right.
Not like in real life.
Do you really like operas?
No, but I feel like I would like opera.
I will never go see an opera with you.
What could be cooler than going to an opera? You have a monocle. You have $1 billion. A beautiful wife.
You don't have to
this
wear a
monocle. This is fucking awesome.
No one wears a monocle anymore at the opera.
Oh, I would.
Would
if
you?
If we're going to an opera.
Would you?
I'm wearing a monocle, a three-piece suit.
Top hat?
Top hat. I'm bringing a concealed gun. Because you got to bring a concealed gun to an opera.
Who says?
I'm just John Wilkes Booth. Not that I like. He's a bad guy. He's a bad guy. But basically, picture John Wilkes Booth. That or Lincoln, both well dressed for the opera. It's a night out, and so yeah, that's why I would go. It wouldn't even really be about the opera. It would be really more about me.
Yeah, like most things.
Going
most things. Also, you would hate operas because most operas aren't even in English. Most operas are like in Italian, German, or like French.
I'm learning Portuguese. I'll figure it out.
So you're gonna sit there. Knowing your like basic conversation Portuguese, and you're gonna sit there like, I think I get the gist.
No, but most people that go to opera don't know those languages, right?
Sometimes, yeah. I would say, yeah.
La patapau. Wee.
You da la puri. You ate my daughter's pudding. You know, it's, yeah.
And now
you catch
I
words.
Have none.
Yeah.
No, I mean, but opera is a musical, isn't it? Is it a type of musical?
I would say opera is in the category of musical. It's probably the original.
Yeah.
Musical.
Yeah, maybe I just like the real thing.
So I'm just saying, you've just welcome to the contradiction zone. You just contradicted yourself. I fucked that up. So I'm sorry, listeners. Sometimes I'm just bad with words. The contradiction.
Your diction was bad.
My diction. I need to work on my diction. This is how I talk now.
I need to work on my diction.
Good one, Sean.
Thank you.
So.
Speaking of music.
Yeah.
Amber Heard is a musician. Isn't she? Isn't she?
No. She's an
actor. I'm so bad.
You're over four today.
Literally, like, I feel like I here's the crazy thing, Tony. I'm so bad at pop culture that people think I'm doing a bit. When I go, like, Amber Heard's a musician, and sometimes I am doing a bit, and that's why they think it's a bit.
Yeah, yeah.
But, like, a lot of the time, I genuinely just don't know what people have done.
Why don't you like pop culture?
I was never exposed to it.
Really?
I missed 10 years of culture.
When?
Starting in, like, ninth grade. Started playing Yu-Gi-Oh! And then I started playing League of Legends, and I got into engineering, and then I got into stocks, and that was just a black hole
you
of
never,
time.
You
I
just,
never, and now I still kind of refuse to consume most things.
Why?
Because it's like not worth my time.
It's kind of cool.
I feel like an obligation to consume stuff now.
Yeah.
As a guy that's supposed to have opinions about stuff. My opinion can't always just be like, oh, I didn't see it.
That's true. Yeah, you can't.
So I've been trying to like, but don't you feel like sometimes like, I just feel like the whole fucking world rammed down my fucking throat. Just a bunch of stuff's always been thrown at you. Amber Heard, Johnny Depp, Joe Biden. It's like, shut up. You know?
No, I get that.
It's exhausting. It's exhausting.
I think it's become more exhausting.
Let me watch Breaking Bad again.
All I want to do is watch Breaking Bad.
Which is what I'm doing.
And play League of Legends. That's all I need.
I don't want to grow up. That's really what it
is. I just need one show.
I could literally rewatch Breaking Bad every year.
And be fine.
And never watch another show again.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
But you know how Breaking Bad makes you feel?
How?
good, right? It makes you feel good, right?
Oh, yeah.
I love how you asked me. That was all right. But
no, I thought it was a
rhetorical.
You were going somewhere with
it. No, but you know how Breaking Bad makes you feel good, right?
Yeah.
There are other shows out there that will also make you feel good.
Not as good as Breaking Bad, though. That's my show.
Why does Breaking Bad make you feel that good?
Because I identify a lot with Walter White. Tony, think about it. I'm getting cancer.
Stop saying that.
All right, I will.
Stop telling people you're getting cancer. Because there are people in this world that are actually getting cancer.
No, I know, yeah.
And you... Because the thing is, I know you're not doing it as a bit. In your mind, you actually think you're getting cancer.
No, I don't. No.
But your doctor literally said 99.9% chance you do
no,
not.
No, she said you probably don't.
It's pretty...
Which is not 99.9.
Probably.
All right, anyway... That aside, I identify a lot with Walter White.
How?
And I feel like you're...
Jesse?
Not Jesse. You're like Gus Fring.
I'm Gus?
Yeah, you're Gus.
So that makes us nemesis?
Oh, nemesis? No. Oh, no. Yeah, I guess so.
We're partners?
Yeah.
But then you're going to blow half my face off? That's good to know. That's good to know that I'm going to die. I'm going to die by your hand one day?
I'm Saul and you're... You're Walter White or Jesse.
No, how do you think you're Walter White?
Just average guy. Not much going on. Kind of a loser. Then he gets into drugs.
Yeah, but...
and he uses his intelligence to be someone. And I think... And he becomes a drug lord. But he's some guy. He's a guy now. He's a force. He's a force of nature.
So you watch Breaking Bad. Most people, just FYI, most people when they watch Breaking Bad, you're watching a man choose this life of like where he thinks it's purpose and he's actually meaningful, but it's actually ruining his real life, his relationship with his kid, his wife, which is actually real relationships full of purpose and meaning. But he's chasing this fake purpose, meaning drugs and money. So you're literally getting the opposite of what the show is trying to teach you.
No, I mean,
the show is trying to teach you, like, hey, yeah, you could become someone and you could become really wealthy and the best in that field, but it will destroy the real importance of your life.
Yeah.
But you watch it going, look at this fucking loser. He made something of himself. And if his wife doesn't get on board, she needs to fucking get the fuck out. That fucking kid.
I'm sorry, his name.
Legs don't work. I'm sorry his legs don't work. Maybe if he had better legs, his dad would fucking hang out with him.
And let him sell meth with him.
Yeah.
Walter Jr.
Walter Jr., yeah.
No, I mean, I get it. It's like I have a fatal attraction to it.
You have okay.
You know.
You told me once that you think you'd be a good drug dealer.
I think I would be a good drug dealer.
You'd get shot.
I would not get shot.
Instantly.
I'm not talking about a low-level guy. I'm talking about like vice president of operations.
Yeah, but you know how you become vice president? You have to start.
Oh, no, you send a resume in?
No, you have.
Is it a few rounds of interviews?
Yeah. You go downtown.
Who do I email, Tony?
You go downtown.
Who do I email?
And you're like, I'm looking to get into the drug business, boys. You're wearing like a Gucci suit.
No, I'm on like 6th Street at like 3 a.m. Excuse me.
I have 6 years of sales.
I know I'm passionate about the product. Excuse me, sir. It's like some guy's just. Passed out on 6th Street. Sir, I want to sell meth. Sir. Oh, God, he's dead.
Could you teach me how to sell meth, please?
Hey.
I'm looking for a new career path, something that will bring me joy and purpose. I think the meth game is really the thing for me.
No, man. I know. It's like he destroys his life and everyone around him and it's sad.
Yeah,
I get it. But
like
the whole point of that show, like the... I'm really like I am attracted. I'm not gonna do it, but I'm attracted to like the thrill, the strategy. I love strategy.
Yeah, why don't you...
And the strategy of selling meth is just fascinating to me.
Why don't you just like...
But I don't want to kill anyone. I don't want people to die. I don't like violence.
Yeah.
I love violence.
Why don't you join like a fantasy football league? There's strategy.
That's lame.
Still strategy. It's
not really.
You can get on the top of the list. Win the championship, win the gold.
But that's gambling. And that's wrong.
True. Gambling's wrong, but selling hard drugs on the street isn't?
Not to me, dude.
All right.
If you want to do them. You hear that?
Yeah, what is that? Someone just hammering away.
I think that's the DEA.
Yeah.
Tony?
Yeah, what if they walk in and they're like, Sean, get on the ground. Get on the fucking ground. We found you. El Chapo ratted you out, motherfucker. You're just like, that piece of shit. We've been in business for 20 years and he'll rat me out like this. And then my face just have my face explodes. And I'm like, I knew this day would come.
Like the end of Departed. Of course I talked to the FBI.
So back to the Amber Heard Johnny Depp trial. Have you been watching?
I have.
What do you
think? It's hilarious. Dude, on YouTube, it's got like 350,000 views.
Yeah.
Everyone's watching it.
Literally everybody.
The Law and Crime Network is like this huge YouTube channel now that like no one knew. No one knew about. Whoever ran that is like, just like, they're like, that's a smart fucking idea. Someone was like, law is content. Court proceedings. Everyone's always loved the drama of court proceedings.
It's true.
So shout out to fuck. I mean, they crushed it.
I follow
this guy. But yeah, like.
Because I follow this guy on TikTok. He's like an old judge and he always does jokes with everybody.
Oh, really?
Yeah, people come in with a ticket and then he'll joke with them and then he'll let them off. And then sometimes it's sad. It's like a single mom and he's like, you work really hard to work for your family. And she's like, yeah, but I can't afford this $50 ticket. And he goes, how about instead of pay that ticket, you take your kids out for a nice breakfast. You promise me that? And they go, yeah. And then they just go and I cry. And it's like, that's a good judge.
Then he goes, I'd like to do that, but 30 days in the county jail. Slam!
Take the kids away.
No, God, please. Dude, I would love a judge that like, yeah, like cracks a joke and then like hints that he's going to let you off easy and then just gives you the fucking life sentence.
Yeah, judges are scary, man.
Dude, judges are crazy scary.
Yeah. They have so much power.
And the way that they like, dude, they're kind of like robot. They're like a good judge. I don't know. I don't even think good judges exist. But like
you. There's not a single good judge.
Anyone, including me and you, technically, anyone that covets power is evil.
Yeah,
and we covet power.
I bet you there are a couple of judges out there that are like, I wanted to become a judge to uphold the law
and
give people their fair day in trial. I bet you there are a good amount of good judges.
You can't be a good judge, dude.
You can't be a good judge?
No.
That's like saying you can't be a good pilot.
No, it's different.
How is
that
different? That's power. You have people's lives in your hand. That's power.
Yeah, but they're totally different jobs. You're not a pilot. You're just like, it's kind of a whatever job.
It's a power position.
Yeah, but like most 99.9% of pilots are the do it. They're like, they're all the same. It's a job. You fly the plane from point A to point B.
I just want to apologize if there are any pilots listening.
Oh my God.
I disagree with everything.
Not the same.
You guys
okay,
are all individual, and I appreciate all
your
guys' individual
skills. Oh my God.
Skills.
Cut the shit, Tony.
You're just throwing out pilots.
What I mean is all the pilots, let me back up. Pilots fly planes. Judge.
Yeah.
I'm you can be a good pilot because a pilot, you just fly people places and it's fun and it's kind of cool. But with judges, you are, I don't think there's corruption in the aviation industry, in the commercial aviation industry.
You don't think there's corruption in the commercial? The past few years, like three planes have just like crashed for no reason, like Boeing planes.
Yeah, three out of how many?
But still, like, and they did some, they looked into it where the problem could have been fixed. But yeah. They're just like, we got to get this plane out.
Oh, no. Well, I mean, okay, but I don't blame the pilots for that. I blame the CEO of Boeing for that.
It's aviation, baby.
But with, let me get back to judges. With judges, you're enforcing laws that are wrong. I mean, like, I don't know. That the whole, it's just fucked, dude. Judges have to enforce laws that they don't agree with.
Yeah, but there are some judges that I've seen where it's like they don't agree with like marijuana laws.
Right.
So they purposely give people like less like community service where they're like, I kind of have to punish you because you have this bullshit law. So they make it as easy as possible. Yeah, I agree. There are egotistical judges. I'm not saying every judge is good, but to say that every judge is bad, and also to say that on a podcast that judges could possibly hear is wild to me. Because as a guy who just got sued, as a guy who will probably get sued again, you probably want judges on your good side.
You're on a exhibit C. Yeah. Sean Riley on his podcast, episode 17.
Fuck judges.
Yo, every judge, suck my fucking cock.
If I see you, I hope you give me the chair. I hope you give me the chair. You won't, bitch.
Yo, judge, it's on site. It's on site. No, but like, yeah, it's like, I don't know. I don't want to say all AJAB, all judges are bastards. I'm not,
You went from bad to bastards.
I went from not good to bastards.
Yeah, to bad.
All
right.
No, I hate to speak in absolutes. I don't want to speak in absolutes, but I am. They're all bad. They're all bad. Sorry.
The judge.
Sorry. Dude, if you're a judge, you like power. You like discipline. It's kind of sexual. Punish me, daddy. Oh, I'm going to punish you. How about 4 years in jail? Yeah. You want a felony, bitch?
Yeah, daddy.
You want a little felony? You want to have trouble getting your job after you get out?
I hate this. Yeah. I hate this so much.
So, all right.
A sexual judge like that? You want a little felony?
Yeah, you want a little felony?
You want a little lethal injection? Yeah?
Give me the misdemeanor. Give me the class C felony. Oh, yeah, you want to bump it up to class B? Give me the class B felony. Oh, yeah, that's strike three. You're out.
15 to 20, bitch.
Chance of parole? None.
So, what do you
anyway,
think?
Whatever. What,
do you think on like these celebrity like judge cases? What's that?
I'm farting.
Are you really?
No.
Oh. Do you think on these like
that was fucking weird? Was this is a weird episode.
This is a very strange episode.
Sorry about that. I don't know what that was.
It was a ghost fart. No. Do you think on these like celebrity?
Is that Mark Zuckerberg? Okay, go.
On these celebrity cases.
Yeah.
Do you think? Do you think they play it up a little bit for show?
That's not even, those aren't even real cases.
What do you mean?
Those aren't real judges,
right?
No,
I'm talking about like the Johnny Depp one.
I thought you meant, Judge Judy.
Well, yeah, I know Steve Harvey isn't actually a judge. I know. Dude, what would you do?
$600 to you.
What would you do if you, okay. Your friend got murdered, right?
Okay.
And you saw the person. You're going in to testify against the person that murdered your best friend. You witnessed him shoot your best friend in the head cold blood. And you go on, you sit down, and they say, "All rise for the judge." And then Steve Harvey comes out, and he goes, "How's everybody doing today?"
All rise.
All rise.
All right, sit down. All right. What's your name?
What's your name? What'd you do? You shot a man in the head? All right, you're crazy. You're a crazy man.
So the defendant, Johnny. So you shot a guy. Allegedly.
Allegedly. But we all know you did it.
Survey says you did it. Ding, ding, ding. All right, for $300, or what is that on the other show? Show me knife in his back.
Honestly, wow, I kind of want to kidnap Steve Harvey. Right? Hear me out. Kidnap Steve Harvey, find a time machine, go back in time, and make Steve Harvey the judge during the OJ trial.
Oh, uh-oh, my God.
The glove, dude. The glove don't fit. And then he just looks in the camera like in Family Feud, just, I guess we have to acquit.
What you'd have to do is go back like 10 years or earlier,
yeah,
and then motivate Steve Harvey to become a trial lawyer and then eventually become a judge in L.A.
That'd be good.
And then
keep that same charisma.
Yeah, keep the same charisma.
He needs to keep that Steve. That would be wild. I think I would be very. So, if I had to go testify for my friend's murder, Steve Harvey came out. I don't know how I'd feel. I think I'd feel a little happy. I'd be like, this guy cool.
If I'm not on trial, I would have a great time with Steve Harvey as a judge. But if I'm the defendant, I don't know. Maybe just he kind of let you off.
You make him laugh.
I like you.
You seem like a good guy. Hey,
I don't think he killed this guy.
Yeah, I don't. Come on. Hey, Jerry, look at him. Look at it. He looks like a pea in a pot.
Bro, you know what other trial I was watching? Dude, I actually love law. Let me ask you this, actually.
You love law, but you hate lawyers.
Yeah.
Okay.
I love the idea of law.
Sean?
This is great.
I love the idea of
Where's
law.
Where's my monocle? No. I love the idea of law.
I love the idea of law. I think, honestly, and I'm not a professional like therapist, but I think my unprofessional take is the reason you hate judges is because you're jealous of the power that they have.
Ding, ding, ding. You got it. It's the same reason I have an authority complex for sure.
Yeah. So you hate law.
Let me ask you a question. I've actually... this is a very fascinating topic to me. So I talk, my uncle's a public defender, really good one. And
I think all public defenders are pieces of shit. What's your uncle's name? First name?
Carl.
Carl, fuck you. You do nothing good in this country.
He's actually a great, great guy. Anyway, he's got, he fucking defends people that get on minor drug charges and stuff and helps them get plea deals. But I was asking him this, which is a really interesting idea to me, is that, remorse, feeling sorry for what you did.
Yeah.
If you get charged with a crime and you're found guilty, let's say you sell, like, I don't know, let's say you get caught with like a scale and like a pound of weed, right? Or no, let's not do that. Let's say you like hit a guy, you got a bar fight and you hit a guy and you put him in a coma. Right? And then he dies. That's like second degree murder, manslaughter. You didn't mean to kill him, but you killed him.
Yeah.
Well, here's the idea. Remorse is a factor in your sentencing. So if I'm judging you, you get found guilty of a second degree murder, whether or not you get life in prison or let's say 30 years with parole, like you get out someday, the difference can be whether or not you feel bad.
Oh, yeah.
And to me, this might be my autism, I don't think that remorse should be a factor in sentencing.
Why not?
Because to me, how you feel has nothing after the crime's been committed has nothing to do with the crime. The crime, if you're found guilty, this is after the trial. Like, you're found guilty, you did the thing, right? And I think when they sentence you, I just don't see why. I don't know. Well, if you go like, I would do it again.
I think so.
But people can be fake. People can show fake remorse.
Yeah, I think so. Though, on that kind of level, though, you can tell. I think you can tell because I think.
But no one's perfect. That's my thing. Is like, but like, how could I know if you're faking it or not?
So my thing is this. If it's like a Ted Bundy situation where he killed like 9 to 15 people. I don't know how many people he killed. He killed a lot.
Like 50, dude. Yeah, a lot.
Like, he killed like 50 people. And then he's like, I'm sorry. Like, sorry, you're getting
locked. Well, I think Ted was like, I'll do it again. Yeah, yeah. I will kill again.
What I'm saying, though, is if it was him and then he was in court going like, I'm sorry, I won't do it again. It's like, bro, you did it 50 times.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. Oh, jeez, man.
Oh, jeez, shucks, guys.
Oh, jeez, shucks. I didn't know I was doing
Catherine,
something
for it. Katie, Cher. Oh, jeez. Jeez. I promise. I'm sorry.
I'm just a simple boy named Ted.
Oh, shucks, Yona. I didn't mean no harm. So my arm was, really was broken.
My arm was. I'm so. My heart is very, very. My heart is broken.
And then they crossed me.
So yeah, I think if it's a repeat offender or someone who did it a lot, yeah. But I think if it's like someone where they have never really committed a crime, or you know, shit happened, and they feel remorse, like they deep down feel like sorry. It's like, I don't think we should make it like, oh, 5 years. But it's like, I think they should have the potential to come back out. You know, in Germany, life in prison is 25 years. That's the most you can get. That's the most you can get for murder. It's 25.
That's actually insane. For first, like for premeditated murder, yeah. 25 years.
Yeah.
And I bet you the murder rates are lower in Germany.
Yeah, let me check. Let me see the prison thing. German.
I mean, 25 years is basically.
German.
That's enough. I don't know, dude.
Because I think the only people that got like death.
Do they have? Well, oh, Europe, shit. Europe in general. What?
In Germany, life imprisonment is called lebenslange Freiheitsstrafe. I'm flexing.
What does that mean? Life imprisonment.
Is the most severe punishment that can be imposed. A person sentenced to life imprisonment may normally apply for parole after having served 15 years. So, yeah, you can get out after 15. Or longer in serious case. Yeah. Most cases, you can get out after 15 years, but for like more serious, it's around 23 years or longer. But yeah, in Germany though, dude, look up German prisons. They seem like the nicest hostels you could ever go to. No, it's true. Like, dude, that's one thing about Germany I think is amazing about their prison system, is in America, you go from like. You commit a crime, you go to jail, and you live in this fucking hell world, just surrounded by people that are still committing crimes. You know, they get treated like shit. You kind of have to join gangs just to survive in prison.
Right.
You know what I mean? So you're just,
yeah.
You're always just staying around kind of like this crime, kind of crime filled life, right? In jail. In Germany, they give you your own cell. You can have a TV in there. Books, plants. Like if you're good, you
it's can, nice. It's very nice.
No, they like sometimes they let them adopt cats. And, that's cool. And they have to work. You wake up. You either go to school in jail, or you take you learn how to become like a woodworker, a mechanic,
like a software engineer.
No, different stuff. You actually
probably
now. And then so they go to class. They graduate. You know, in jail. And then when they get out of prison. Germany offers like tax like cuts to businesses that hire these prisoners, and so they work for those companies for free for 1 year, or they pay them but a small amount like as an audition, and then if they hire them, you know, they get a tax cut, and then so literally these people go to jail, they learn something, they find a meaning in life, and then when they get out of jail, they have a job, they have housing. So it's like
some money,
a little money. So, because here in America, dude, you work in America, but I think they only make like 30 cents an hour.
Oh, in prison?
Yeah, let's see.
Dude.
American prison wages.
It's, oh man, it's nothing, dude.
Because I think it's like literally.
No, it's below.
Typically wages range from 14 cents to $2 an hour. For prison maintenance labor, depending on the state.
Holy
the
shit. Inmate that's crazy.
The national average hovers around 63 cents per hour. Dude, it is.
Tony.
Dude, that's like literally when people say like prison is like modern day slavery, it is.
Well, I mean, and I'm still wondering, Tony, no one wants to work anymore. And I don't know why. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
No one wants to work anymore.
Yeah.
Not even prisoners.
Take
that. Yeah. I'm in jail.
How about
get a job?
Yeah. How about you save that 63 cents an hour and buy a Bored Ape, you dumb piece of shit? Get yourself an NFT.
Hey, maybe after 60 years of work, you'll be able to buy one Ethereum.
Dude, I would love that. Gary Vee going to a prison, look, trying to teach them how to like invest.
Have you heard of dropshipping? Have you heard of dropshipping? You don't even need to move the inventory. Yeah. It's all done for you on the webs online.
Just go garage sailing. Just go garage sailing. And the guy's like, hey, man, we can't leave.
Hey, man, there's chains around my ankles.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck. Stop bitching.
Stop bitching. Get out there. Break out of jail every day. Go garage sailing. Come back. Serve your time. Next morning, break out. Go garage sailing. Repeat until you're successful.
Like, you got Gary Vee in the cafeteria. He's like, how much for the cigarette? I don't know, man. $10? How about, I'll give you five. I'll give you $5 for the cigarettes.
Come on, man. It's my only cigarette. Okay, four.
Okay, two. Come on, man. Come on, Gary.
Gary Vee would die in prison.
Look.
Gary Vee would die.
I don't know. That's an interesting proposition. Do you think Gary Vee would do well in prison?
No.
I mean, he's never been in a real conflict in his life.
Yeah,
like
he
me.
Would not. Yeah. That's why, dude. I think.
Like, as soon as Gary Vee gets hit in the face.
Dude, the thing is, in American prisons, there's a reason. They're scary. Dude, the scariest shows at nighttime growing up as a kid was like.
Oh, like on real TNT life prisons?
Or AEW or ANW, where it's like locked down, locked up. And you're just like,
oh. Yeah, like real. It's almost like a porn. Like real prisoners locked up.
Yeah.
Forever.
Forever. And you're just like, Jesus.
And then the jail.
And you watch it and you're just like, this doesn't seem right. And then everybody's like, man, this is crazy. This is good that we do this to these people. And it's like, yeah, this doesn't seem right. There's just like nine people living in a closet. This doesn't seem like a.
No, I mean, it's well, you know where the conditions are a little bit better is in the private prisons. Like they are better in the private. Like I'm a shareholder in one of the largest private prisons, and yeah, the conditions are better. Look it up. Core Civic Incorporated is the name of the company, and I own about 2% of the company, and which means I own 2% of the prisoners. Labor.
Hey,
it's a $2 billion company.
I'm a good man. I let these people work for 50 or 65 cents an hour. That's 2 cents more than the national average. I'm a good man.
Do I have Bitcoin mining facilities underneath the jail? Yes.
Do I literally make the prisoners mine coins for me? Yes. Am I getting really wealthy off of their hard labor?
Yes.
Also, yes.
Are they going to get out? No.
No, I'm definitely.
Do I pay the judges to extend their sentences so they can do labor for me longer?
Yes.
I'm thinking about it.
Am I going to help them find a job after they get out? Maybe help them get through anger management? No. Because we want them to come back. Jail is like summer camp. It's fun. So make sure you come back. It's free. It's a meal.
How about a private prison musical? Hey,
I think Elvis did that called Jailhouse Rock.
Yeah, but that's a public that's a jail owned by the taxpayer though. I'm talking about private Elvis, Jailhouse Rock.
Elvis made prison fucking tight.
And look, everyone was in the back of the jail and doing crack.
Yeah, dude. Like, look. Listen to the song. Like,
we don't want to get sued. We've been fine so far, right?
Only play like a few seconds.
Yeah, play like.
But like.
Oh yeah, it goes everybody at Jailhouse Rock. Everybody, let's a rock. Put it up. What? Oh yeah, I love this song. The county jail. Yeah. Let's rock.
Yeah, like that.
No. Everybody, let's rock.
If that was prison, I would commit a crime today.
He came up to me, but then I punched him in his fucking face.
Yeah. Do you think Elvis, after making that movie, he goes, man, I just want to go to prison and check this out. And he walks in, he goes, 1, 2, 3, and the fuck, I got shanked. Ah, goddamn it. Get me out of here.
Yo, Elvis, it's time to put in work for your gang, bro. Yeah. Put in some work.
Okay. If a show, let's say Travel Channel hit you up, right? $100,000. You, like, undercover, and go to jail for 6 months, would you do it?
Isn't there a show? There's a show that does that, right?
Yeah, yeah. Would you do it?
60 days in or something
yeah,
like that?
Yeah, yeah. Would you do it?
100 grand mm-hmm. for how long?
6 months.
In a maximum security prison?
Maximum security.
Like, well, do I have to get to the top of the hierarchy, or do I just have to survive? Like, do I have to like be top bitch?
No, you just have to.
Or top bitch.
You have to get through it.
100,000?
100,000.
I would do.
100,000.
No, for 6 months, no.
That's like scary.
I would do it for a month for 100,000.
I don't think mentally I could do it.
Well, dude, it takes a month to adjust. Here's my thing: is like everyone, like you ever heard the quote, "A man with meaning can survive almost any condition." Mm-hmm. I believe that. A man with someone who has like hope, it's very powerful. You can survive anything with hope.
Yeah.
So
you're right, and I agree with you. But I think
you might have
if I was getting gang raped. Raped by Nazis, my hope would fleet very fast. I would I would go into prison with a lot of hope, and then the Nazis would come and they would gang rape me, and then I would be like, oh, bye Obama, hope is gone.
No, like after one day of that, I like call you up. I'm like, hey Tony, how's the hope going? Not great. It's gone.
It's pretty much depleted, Sean. Yeah.
Yeah, that quote, kind of bullshit. It's kind of a bullshit quote.
Hey, sorry, buddy. I got to go. They're coming back for round two. And I'm just gonna get mentally prepared, all right?
I need about 5 hours to like meditate on this.
Get me out of here. They can keep the money. Just get me the fuck out of here.
I'm going to kill myself. Nah, man. Jail's wild. Dude, I've actually read a lot about like the history of private prisons and how basically it's fucked up, dude. As you can probably imagine, where like this guy, like there was these three guys. It's a very fucked up idea. It's imagine you have say you're a billionaire, right? Trying to make some more money. And you see these overcrowded jail cells.
Yeah.
It's all you have to do. That's how fucked up America is, dude. If I have $1 billion, I can call up Mr. Senator. Senator Johnson, like, hey, Senator, I noticed prisons are not great. How about I set up a prison for you, and you pay me every year. You give me $1 billion a year, and I'll give you some extra space to put all these prisoners. And then you just get a bunch of fucking money from the government to run your own prison.
It's crazy.
It's crazy, and that's legal, dude.
Oh yeah.
It's insane.
It's great. And dude, if you see some of the food they're served, it's like nuts.
It's not even food.
It's like, it's crazy. It's like, because my thing is this. I believe in second chances. I'm a big, again, for certain people. If you're like a serial.
Elizabeth Holmes, yes, second chance.
Elizabeth Holmes, second chance.
Bernie Madoff, second chance. Three chances. Yeah. Let's give him at least four.
Jeffrey Epstein, he was just a yes man. He just wanted to make people happy. No, but like, I believe like.
He was a yes man.
I believe that most criminals in jail, it is literally, it's like for drug offenses or even like gang stuff, where it's like, dude, they had no other option. Like, my favorite thing is when people are like, man, you didn't have to join a gang. Okay. You go live in some of these communities where it's like, man, you either join a gang or you're the enemy of this gang. It's like, I'm joining the gang. You know, it's so much easier to say that if you've never seen the community or you've never been in those communities. And I just think if you just taught people in jail, got them through anger, you know, like helped them get through their anger, helped them learn a skill, helped them learn something that when they get out of prison, they can live a life. Boom.
Yeah.
People would commit less crimes. Because, dude, most people go to jail broke, then they come out of jail, and they're broker than before. So what do they have to do? Commit another crime?
Yeah. Dude, have I ever told you about, you know, as you know, I grew up in the Silicon Valley, like, how many gangs there were in the Silicon Valley?
How many gangs?
Tony, when I grew up in right near Cupertino, California, Apple's HQ is like right there. A lot of gang violence.
Yeah.
I would walk down the street. Just, it'd be like 1, 2 a.m. I'd be in a park.
Yeah.
And, you know, some guys would come up to me. I'd just be hanging out, smoking weed.
You're like, I recognize that black turtleneck. Oh, no.
What? And I'd be like, guys, run. And one night, I tripped and everyone else, all my friends got away and I stayed behind. And these guys in these turtlenecks, they said, they gave me this laptop and they said, we need you to write an algorithm. And they fucking held me down and they made me code an algorithm. They're like, we want you to work at Apple. And I'm like, I don't want to put in work like that. That's not who I am. You know, like, but that's how it is out there.
Yeah.
That's what I had to go through. So, like, when you talk about...
I like
about
to imagine gangs in Silicon Valley. It's like, what's that movie? West Side Story? Yeah. Where it's just, like, the Spielberg... Not the Spielberg. The Steve Jobs versus the Zuckerbergs. Hey, we're the Zuckerbergs.
It's blue and white. Oh, really? Is there a red?
Blue.
Blue's Facebook. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What's red? DoorDash?
DoorDash.
Oh, no. DoorDash and Facebook are at it again.
Stop the violence. Stop the killing.
I'm so glad I never had to join a gang. The closest I met a gang member. He would, because in shirts, it was weird. This is also why I think.
Don't get us killed, by the way.
This is also why I think weed should just be legal. Because, like, you're literally making high school kids sometimes have to buy weed from very bad people. And like dangerous, almost, you put us in dangerous situations where if like weed was just legal, we could just pay an older person to go to the fucking store and buy us,
yeah,
you know, like a joint. I remember we're at my buddy Kevin's house and he was living with his grandma and they were out of town. So we're like, let's, you know, we're playing video games. How about we go buy some weed? That'd be dope. So we call a guy, and he shows up in a Gran Torino, like a nice Gran Torino car. And, you know, fucking, I was like, oh, this guy's moving supply if yeah, he's driving like a $40,000 car, right? And he comes inside and pulls out a bag, big bag of weed, and he's like weighing it out. He's like, sorry, I didn't have time to weigh it out. And then he just puts a pistol down on the counter. And he's just like, yeah, that's just in case y'all try to pull some shit. And I just go, look at me, look at my friends, we're fine. Like, we're not, yeah, we didn't, like, invite you into our home. We're not pulling anything.
You know what I would have done, Tony? Pull out my pistol, and this is for if you pull some shit.
Yeah. And then, it was weird. He was a bad drug dealer, though, because he goes, y'all want to smoke? And we're like, my buddy Kevin's like, sure. And I was like, hey, Kevin, maybe let's not have the guy with the gun hang out with us.
I would
more
be the guy that says, sure. Yeah.
So at one point, we're smoking, and then we're just high, and we're laughing, and then Kevin just goes, can I hold your gun? And the guy goes, yeah. And he just gives Kevin the gun, and it was not a fun.
So where's, like, the sip?
No, it was not good. It was not fun. But I was like, you're not good at drug dealing. Now you just gave us your weapon. But I think he knew we were pussy-ass bitches, and we were not going to do it.
Was he in a gang, or was he a solo operation, you think?
I think you kind of have to. If you're moving that much supply, you kind of have to work with people.
True.
He, like,
or I wouldn't know.
Apparently, he got, like, I remember after I graduated, I asked about him because I went back home during spring break. And I was like, oh, let's get some weed. And I was like, let's go through this guy. And they're like, we can't. And I'm like, why? And they're like, oh, he's in the hospital. And I go, why? And I was like, oh, guy just showed up to his house, beat him up with a baseball bat. Fuck. Stole his supply. And I was like, yeah, that sounds about right. So yeah, Sean, this is me telling you, hey man, just stay in the finance and comedy world. It's a lot safer.
What you're saying is coke is safer. Should do coke or meth.
Coke
or
is even more dangerous than weed. Imagine getting hit over the head with a baseball bat because you're selling hippie lettuce.
The thing is, Tony, I'm not afraid of death.
Yes, you are. You literally, for the past week, have been touching your neck going like, I have cancer. So, yeah, I know you are.
No, but, yeah. Wow. Well, should we talk about What's your take on this Amber Heard story? Before we wrap up, I am actually curious. What do you think about the whole thing?
I think it's weird. I think she's a piece of shit, but also like I think I don't think Johnny would be here if he knew how to save his money. Because literally, he's broke, and he's suing her for $50 million because like he lost Pirates of the Caribbean 6 because of it. He was gonna get paid like almost $30 million.
Wait, so does he just live extravagantly? Where did all his money go?
Dude, he would spend like $30,000 a month on wine.
On wine?
On wine alone. For his different houses, just collectible wine. Like, yeah, the dude.
For like a brand, like did he have a wine business?
No.
Or is it just buying
collecting
wine?
And he was crazy. Dude, he owned like 10 houses across the world. Like,
Jesus.
So my thing is this. If the dude learned how to save a little bit of his money, I don't think he'd be in this situation of suing her. I think it's fucked up. It seems like an unhealthy relationship on both parts. But like, I don't know. I just think it's so funny. I think it's so funny how people like feel so sorry for him. Like, I feel sorry for him, too, that he was in a relationship with a woman like this. And I feel sorry for him that she, like, kind of threw his name in the dirt. Like, he seems like a good guy. Like, he doesn't seem like one of these Hollywood actors that have done, like, monstrous fucked up shit.
Right.
And it sucks that she literally, like, there's audio where she goes, oh, they're going to believe a straight white man? Yeah, you're fucked. And it's like, oh, bitch, you're crazy. Like, she needs to get punished for that using, you know.
Oh, or she was like, tell the world, yeah, I, Johnny Depp, am a straight white man, is a victim of domestic abuse.
Yeah. So that's fucked up.
That's out of a movie. That line's out of a movie.
Because domestic abuse does happen, and it's terrible, and it shouldn't, you know. So yeah,
It is mostly women,
but it does happen to men.
It does happen to
men, yeah. And so, but my thing is this. Man, dude, you could have saved your like piggy bank a little bit better. Like a little bit better. Like it's crazy how people are feeling sorry that Johnny Depp is broke. And it's like, bro, you got paid hundreds of millions of dollars to put on different kinds of hats. You got paid a lot of money to wear different hats.
Oh my god, I haven't seen Pirates in so long. It's the Black Pearl.
It's the Black Pearl. This is the day you thought you captured.
All right, Johnny, here's $100 million.
And it's crazy. And it's crazy. And it's like, bro, like, I don't think if I make that much money, I don't know.
I'm okay with like getting hit a little bit sometimes.
No, but it's crazy to think. It's crazy to think that he just spent it all.
Oh, yeah. Dude, I mean, I could just...
And he's still young.
Young is he?
He's like in his 50s. But he's only had money for like probably like 15, 20 years.
Yeah.
15 maybe. He's like the Pirates
came
out.
New rich,
yeah,
whatever.
Pirates, because he came from like a poor background. It's also weird. He's from Kentucky, but he speaks British. That's strange. That's like a few...
He's a PSYOP. Yeah,
that's
CIA.
That's a couple...
They're both CIA, actually.
Yeah. It's like, bro, you're not Willy Wonka anymore, man. Get out, you know?
Also, crap. I hated the remake.
It's bad. But I'm just saying, it's crazy to feel bad for a man where they're just like, he's broke now. Johnny is broke now. And it's like, bro, just sell like a house.
Sell
like two of them.
Dude, could you imagine like Johnny Depp's on the stand? He's like crying. He's like, I was in Madrid enjoying a cocktail. It was beautiful in my house. It's recently appraised at 25, 30 million.
Yes.
And then Amber came out and threw a Red Bull at my head.
No, I'm not even...
And I said, that's not nice, Amber. This is a very nice house.
I'm not even making fun of the domestic stuff. The domestic stuff is bad. I'm not trying to poke fun that he got hit in the head.
Okay, I don't know. Was this like... Okay, no, that is fucked. But like, dude, you're in a beautiful house on a balcony.
That is a fucked up thing to say.
And like,
you're going for it.
It's
Sean.
It's cost benefit analysis. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, Sean, you're going for it. You're like, if you live in a... So basically, hear me out. Based off your set of principles, wait, what's her name? Let me pull up the name before I say it. a second.
Amber Heard.
No.
Oh, you're bringing up some other shit. You're gonna make me feel bad about myself.
So you're saying Nicole Brown, who got who got murdered by O.J. Simpson. You know, yeah, you got murdered and boo hoo, but you got murdered in a pretty nice house.
It was in Bel Air, was it not? Was not that house not in Bel Air?
Yeah, if I was gonna get murdered, I would want it to be in Bel Air.
Or you not stabbed in your Tesla.
Yeah.
Was it a Tesla Model 3 with turbocharge?
Yeah.
Yes, it was.
So yeah, my whole thing
no,
is...
No, you're right.
My whole thing is
it's just hard to have sympathy for the rich also.
No. It's like, it's not that it's rich. It's just when people are just like...
You're talking about him actually suing for defamation. Well, dude, to me, I don't think Johnny gives a fuck about the money.
I think
it's a principle. It's the why would he go through all this public?
Because he needs the money. He's broke.
You're telling me Johnny Depp is actually broke?
Johnny Depp is like,
what? Like, he defaulted on his mortgages. Like, are you talking about like, celebrity broke? His name alone, he could do a movie and make a. You know what I mean? I don't know.
Johnny Depp. Let's see.
Or sell his wine. Sell the wine.
When Depp revealed his financial woes in court, he claimed his business manager stole his money and left him owing $100 million in taxes. That's not good. Apparently, he had made $650 million and I had made $650 million, and when I sacked them for the right reason, I had not only lost $650 million, but I was $100 million in the hole. Because they did not pay my government taxes for 17 years.
But is that his fault? I'm sure there's lots of details about, like, I'm sure he'll get the money back.
Wow.
Because if he was taken advantage of, that's not his fault that he was fucked by other people. He should have some restitution for that.
That's crazy.
Also, who's doing his fucking, you know, who's managing his money if...
Yeah, that is crazy. I would like.
I don't know, man. I would. That's kind of a yellow flag for me. I'm like, bro, you can get. You're not broke. He's gonna get some of that money back if he was stolen from, right?
I don't know.
Unless they used Ethereum. What if Johnny was like, they bought something called a Bored Ape, and now all of my.
How do you just like? You're worth $650 million. You look at your bank account and you're just like, huh. I spent $100 million this year? Like, I would, like, I don't know. I feel like I would double check.
Or just, well, dude, I mean, you know, people with that sort of passion, they just, you know, people have different priorities in their life. So I could kind of get if he was just like, hey, man, maybe he has a call every month.
I trust you.
Hey, bro, sounds good.
Yeah, that is crazy. That is crazy. Taxes. Yeah. Owing $100 million to the government.
I mean, I would, and you know what? They'll get it.
Yeah, they're gonna get it.
That's, you know, like if like a bank loans you money, you can be like, hey, I'm bankrupt, and the bank's like, oh, okay.
The government's like,
no.
Yeah, I don't know.
Now, Johnny, you're gonna
pay. I shouldn't say this on the podcast, but I probably owe a few thousand of the taxes.
All right, well, we cut that out. We're back, guys.
No, we can. No, I don't care.
No, I'm joking.
I lie on my taxes.
Who doesn't?
I'm not rich enough where I'm like worried they'll come after me.
And by who doesn't, I mean I don't.
Do you have a tax man?
Yeah.
I don't. I do it myself.
Okay.
And it's crazy. And I'm a independent contractor. So like TurboTax, they just make you pay $100 and like to get the independent contracting thing. And
so, dude, and all the people that are independent contractors are like fucking DoorDash.
Oh, yeah.
They're already hurting for cash.
Yeah.
And they like upcharge you.
Oh, yeah. It's crazy.
Everything in this world is pushing you towards being a fucking wage slave.
Yeah.
They want you to be a salaried employee.
I don't care. Because my thing is like, come after me for like the $2,000 I owe. Let's go to court for 9 months. Come after me.
Yeah, Tony, you say that, and then it happened to me. You don't want to go to court for 9 months.
That's true.
It's a headache.
That's true.
Yeah, man, it's a wild. And also, it's like these taxes. I'm like, bro, I don't. I mean, yeah, I'm okay to not give the government a little bit more money so that they can buy missiles. You know?
Yeah, that's a thing too, where it's like our weapons prices just keep getting up, and our weapons budgets. It's just like, really?
51% of the budget, I think, goes.
Like, I'm like almost in. I'm making like $30,000 a year. Do you really need my $800 to fucking have a missile to bomb a country in the Middle East?
Tony, like, there's a lot of school buses in Syria.
I'm pissed. There's like a fucking tire that I bought for a tank that just got left in Afghanistan, and it's just like, cool. I bought that tire.
Or like, you know those videos of the soldiers that just fire the javelins?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
For fun? Just like, that's for my entire life of taxes in one. You had fun? My entire life of taxes is going towards you guys having fun for 5 seconds.
How about you train on a simulator?
Yeah.
Train on a simulator.
So wait, I just pay, like, let's say I pay, like, I don't know, $1 million over my whole life in taxes or something, like $500K, whatever. Or Johnny Depp paying $100 million.
Yeah.
And it's just like, fire in the hole. It sounds cool. It makes a little bloop, bloop, bloop.
But before we get out of here, I just want to say, I am rooting. I think Johnny's going to win. My money's on Johnny. I think he's going to win. And I hope he gets a life together. And I hope Amber Heard doesn't physically abuse people anymore.
Right.
It sucks.
Because that's fucked up. That's fine. And I think this case has been good for, like, awareness. Not just of, like, men getting abused, domestic abuse, but also just in general.
I think just abuse in general.
Because, watching it is very hard.
And I think
it's very emotional to watch it.
Yeah, and I think it's also not just, like, physical abuse. It's also, like, psychological. Like, a lot of it was, like, psychological abuse. And it's like, that's a real fucking thing.
Yeah.
That is crazy. Dude, also the idea of them just recording each other, it's like, bro, that's a bad relationship. If you're in a relationship where you're just like, oh, my girl's coming over, I better click record.
Yeah.
You're not, you know, the butterflies are gone.
Like,
the butterfly phase is over.
No, like Amber Heard comes in. Hi, Amber Heard. Hello. Johnny, why are you saying my full name? What do you mean, Amber Heard?
Amber Heard, my beautiful girlfriend.
Are you fucking recording me?
Yeah, you got me.
Gotcha.
But I think that's the episode.
Yeah, well,
we're hour 12 in, long episode. But
cover a lot of ground today.
Yeah, we had fun.
Yep.
Thank you guys for listening, like always. Thank you guys for subscribing.
If you're a new listener, thanks for joining.
This is cool.
We got a bunch of new downloads, so thanks for being a part of the fucking crew. This is awesome.
And me and Sean, we're starting to shoot some sketches, so those will be on the same YouTube page, just under a playlist under Thoughtless Sketches, and there's one up right now, and check those out. And as always, you can find me at Comedian Tony C.
Sean Reilly Comedy.
And if you like us, leave a comment, leave us a review, thumbs up, all that.
Subscribe.
Do we even
need to say it? I mean, we do, though.
We do, but like, just do what you want.
Yeah, there's always those podcasts. Like,
I would rather
say it every time.
If it was between you giving us a review and not tuning in, I'll pick you guys tuning in.
Yeah, just listen. You, honestly, I'd rather you listen and just like block us.
Yeah.
Fucking how about you block us on Instagram and
honestly keep listening to the podcast. Can you guys stop listening so that I can get the hint and get a job and live a good life, you know? So I can make some money, open up a private prison, and actually make some bank.
Tony and Sean's private prison.
Yeah, the Thoughtless
prison.
It's coming. All right, guys. All right. Thanks for listening.
Bye, guys. Bye. See you next time.